Hello there, and as usual, I'm Aaron from Laststandgamers, and welcome. So today I want to go behind the scenes at the DFR base, otherwise known as the drone faction, the faction that I control. I wanted to show you all the really cool hidden features, give you a bit more information on some of the parts, some of the creations that our drone members have been building, but more importantly, I wanted to touch on this today because we are holding back on the Colony Wars episodes till next week. The reason for this is me and Jack really want to polish these episodes up, make them perfect, make them really exciting to watch, and we need a little bit longer to do it. And I have to say, the dog attack gets a little bit crazy. Something to definitely look forward to. Anyway, without any spoilers, let's get inside. So we're going to work our way into the center of the facility first. So as we come through the hangar bay door, we enter into the main facility area that we'll be coming back through, talking about the ships in this section. We enter into the bunker itself. Now we're down into the bunker segment, we're actually into the refinery room. This is the heart of the place. On this side, we have ourselves 10 refineries, nicely labeled, and some catwalks have been connected up. Not super functional, but Aaron just decided to do it for a bit of beautification of this room as it needed it. It was too perfect. Hardman made a really good job of making it super efficient, but it just needed some extra catwalks to make it look a little bit pretty. So we've got assemblers on this side, double stacked, and you can see they've got all the efficiency modules on there. So these guys can pretty much suck in ore and pump out parts as fast, well, faster than we actually require them. In some points, we actually have to put them producing more points. So you can see we've just got them producing random different parts at random different intervals, so we never run out of supplies in any case. Down here, we've got ourselves some turrets, and we've also got these extra areas that will eventually probably lead into other parts of this facility if we get a chance to build that. Now, coming back into the center of the bunker, we have ourselves the med block. So the med block through here, the simple med bay there, tucked into that section. It's not the only med bay in the facility. The other ones are kept a little bit quiet and off camera. And you'll also notice that there is a number of cameras spread out throughout the base. Now, I installed these after I thought we had some slackers within the drone army. So I've got these all over the place. I can monitor work in different sections, zoom in, check out different things that are going on, and just really keep an eye on my workforce, make sure they're working hard. And if not, I can always do some nice punishment for them. Now, coming over to this section, we have ourselves the hidden refinery. It's not really hidden because I've told you where it is, but eventually this will be blocked up. We've also got ourselves some battery cells in here. Hardman was working on sort of extending this area up. The whole idea of it is not to be pretty, this particular section, just to have various refineries or sort of reactors tucked away within the walls of the facility so that if one fails, then we've got more. So back through this section, we now enter into the airlock that a lot of the drones really don't understand. There's something in the hard wiring is failing because we've got this massive this door sign so people know which way of going. Now, as we come through here, we have ourselves the airlock process that opens and closes like that. We also have the lockdown. So the lockdown facility will actually cause this place, if I can. You'll see all the doors will actually lock up, except that access door. So we can exit the facility, we can't enter it, and if we need some protection, say for instance, we need some firepower going on, let's just open that up. As we exit through these doors, I think something's been pressed incorrectly here because that one's going up and all these are going down. Usually that goes down. We have the Gatling guns along the top here to suppress the enemy as we enter and exit the bunker. And at this stage, both the doors can be let open and we just keep running out until we push the attackers back. So over there, Starbuck, we've seen that particular ship before. It's got a number of missile launchers on the top. We've got some Gatling guns on the side, and it's got these protective wheel arches, very nicely built by Ryan there, and it seems to constantly get modified, but it's hidden in the bunker, of course, for its own protection. Now, on this side, we have Finch's sort of recon drones. Well, that's what we've been using them as. You can see on either side here, we've got ourselves a lovely little recon craft, and originally it's set out without these antenna wings on it, but one day it showed up with the extra missile pods, the extra firepower, and you know, Aaron cannot turn down extra firepower. So if I just teleport my character over here for a second and we pop into one of these, they're very nimble, they can get recon done a variety of different distances, they have quite a good bit of range, and as we can see, we can move around the facility quite easily. Let's just pop out here. So if we pop over into this section, we have the Beetles. The Beetles have kind of been mothballed for the moment because their armor is good, the weapons package is pretty average,
But the main capability is to transport troops around, and since everyone's got their own rover, we don't really need this capability at the moment. But they're still in here, and they still seem to drive around pretty well. Sometimes they get some issues where the wheels clip on the wheel arch and they get a little bit stuck, but still a very efficient little drone, unless Aaron rams it into Drunken's Miner. So there we go. We've got Drunken's Miner over there, the Disco Miner, that dug out this massive big hole that he has yet to do anything with. When he started digging this, I was a little bit confused. I didn't know what his plans were. But you can see we have some really funky lighting glitches down here in the basement now. So let's go back to the spectator camera and let's continue moving around the place. So as we come out through the main entrance, you'll notice we've got a little bit of a button panel. We've actually had a few security issues with this door. The original one was that we had a connector going out of it because we were a little bit lazy. We didn't want to wire one in through the back wall. We've now wired that into the back wall, so this place fully seals up under attack. And it is definitely required. It stops people from just jetpacking into our main facility. Now out front, we have Apathy's little rover. When he first joined the survival, I just said to him, get building. Get us a little rover built up, and this is what he came up with. So you can see it's just a simple little rover, two Gatling turrets, some ammunition storage, as well as some batteries. Just a quick, simple rover that delivers a little bit of firepower. Now, this is what left of the recon mission from the previous Colony Wars episode. On the way back, Drunken decided to park this thing in the door. Someone activated the door, and it crushed it. So that's the issue with that particular recon rover. Up here we have the outer docking port. Now the outer docking port also has a spare med bay, so if you don't want to respawn and run through the whole facility, you can spawn outside. It's just another quicker way of getting back into the battle. On top of it, we've got two of the Muffins. Muffins are our sort of multi-utility type ship. They've got Gatling guns, they've got welders, they could pretty much be attached with anything, and they work in a whole variety of situations and are not too expensive to build. Now as we come up into this section, you'll notice that there's a load of dogs all over the place. We started to try to connect the dogs up to the actual BB's ship, but Aaron was testing it out before and he dropped all the dogs, so that's something you'll have to wait for the next episode to see. Now continuing over here, we've got the welder pit and we have the cabin. Now in the later episodes we realized that this is causing a lot of performance issues on the server, mainly due to accessing the welders underneath. The welders underneath them weld up blocks that should be completed. That's what I believe the issue is. But as we continue over here, we have the beginning of the solar farm, and the batteries in the base are now being charged by this solar farm that will eventually stretch all the way down the side and just give us another source of power in case we drop off the grid or we run out of uranium. That's a very big possibility. So moving a bit further down, we have the first ship or rover we ever built. This is a little bit of a mobile HQ. Inside here we've got everything we need to survive, an assembler, refinery, as well as a little med bay in there as well. And that helps us pretty much construct the whole of the inner workings of this base until we got the own refinery room built up. Now coming a little bit further over there, past BB's V welder slash currently dog dropper, we have Pabble's Classic. This one's the command variant. We've got three antennas, so when we do launch the dog attack, we have a way of basically just guaranteeing that we keep control of them even if this thing gets shot up. So you can see we've got them there. We've got ourselves the cockpit at the front. We've also got a cockpit in the center and a redundancy in camera systems. A really nice rover this. We've talked about this one a lot though, so I won't go any further with that. Over here, on fire, of course we have the OG floor cleaner, BB's sort of hover vehicle that uses friction. I tried to pilot it before when I was testing out before this video, making sure all the ships were working. Of course, Aaron crashed it into Finch's rover over here. So you can see there's a big dent in the side of Finch's rover because I decided to crash that thing into it. Anyway, it'll be reset before the recording, so the guys won't have to worry about all the things being damaged by Aaron messing around. But you can see on Finch's hover rover, we have a lot of firepower. And what I like about this one particularly is if you're engaging a target at the front, all them cannons can target it and it gets absolutely wasted, especially with these cannons in the lower part of the hull. A very, very nice design by Finch. He's also got some protection on the side, nicely tucked away in there as well. It's really like a land battleship, this one. So we've had a quick look at the rovers. There is one rover I've missed that I know is just over here, and this is just the floor welder. So every time we're building a floor up, like this section over here, we just drive this guy, fill it with the resources, and just weld up the floor panel. It's just a lazy way of doing floors that can be really tedious and boring in other sort of attitude. The final thing I want to add is this base really needs an overhaul when it comes to defenses. You can see how lacking we are. We're starting to build this 300mm gun port up at the top. Fingers that'll be crossed. And we've also got some defences starting to take shape up here on this little battery. But the plan is we're going to surround this whole valley area with a number of different batteries. Now, the final comment I wanted to add to this is this little creation here. Now, this is Apathy's Battle Duck. The idea of it is just a whole selection of weapons. It's going to be basically a land battleship. We'll see how it actually works out when it gets finished, if it gets finished and it doesn't get destroyed in an attack. Anyway, lads, thank you guys for watching, and I really hope you're looking forward to next week's colony survival. It is going to be crazy. There is a massive battle. That is all I'm going to say. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.